like a piece of pulse.
Pulse? What, you mean like the Bodom vestige? Something like that. It's close to Eden.
Yeah, well, what I don't understand is after the purge and all that Lassie paranoia, why keep a chunk of pulse under the floorboards?
Is this what the Primarch wanted us to see?
A place for Lassie to accept their fate.
Do you really think our focus is what Dysley said it is?
You mean become Ragnarok?
Destroy the fal'cie Eden and shatter Cocoon. That's what the vision's telling us, more or less. So, we're back to square one. Out of luck.
Mr. Hero! Cocoon calling Snow!
It's almost like Dysley wants it to come true.
Seems that way. He sure didn't mind explaining it. Here's your focus on the silver platter.
But that doesn't make sense. I don't get it. Why would a cocoon fal'cie want to destroy Cocoon?
Maybe it's a fal'cie thing. You know what I mean? Some grand design we just don't understand.
Huh. Hey, Snow. Nothing from you?
So, this way?
He was talking about was that crazy Ragnarok dream we all had when we were made into Lassie. One of us is supposed to become this Ragnarok thing and destroy Eden, except we do that by destroying this orphan that gives Eden its... I think I have that part straight now. Are we ready to get out of here?
Yes. That's why I'm heading this way.
Yeah, I gotta apologize. Looks like I was wrong.
About Sarah's focus? Not like you to second-guess yourself.
Well, even heroes make mistakes.
What about your plan to protect Cocoon? Either way, your faith in Sarah was strong. That strength got you this far.
It was all wrong.
Yeah. You tried so hard to convince us that you even fooled yourself. You've been a total idiot. But still... saved me. You trusted Sarah. Let that faith drive you. It even made me want to believe.
Creepy.
Ah!
for another approach.
If the controller is actually turned on. I guess this one died even though it was charging. Just sitting there like, why the hell is nothing happening?
Keep the enemy off balance.
Party is trash. I hope I can switch. This is terrible.
They called them.
Long ago, the fal'cie, who made their home on Grand Pulse, were afraid of invasion from the outside. As part of their battle preparations, they created an army of living weapons, and they stored those weapons in arks, and they hid the arks all over the world.
Everyone on Grand Pulse knew the legend.
So, this is basically a Pulse armory.
Mm-hmm. Most of us never believed in it. A few people tried searching, but they never found a thing. Who'd have thought to look on Cocoon?
Right under our noses. Some secret they kept. Yeah, those Sanctum guys, what are they up to?
The story's not done. There's more.
They used to say the Ark's had a more practical purpose.
Really?
Yeah, to force Lassie to master their shiny new powers.
Okay, so, I get it. Dysley's goal is to forge us into stronger weapons, right?
Not Seath, but monsters all the same.
Think of it as training for the fight ahead.
Herb's right!
Wait, what was that? These guys again.
Fun times.
Over there. We gotta keep moving.
There was a treasure ball somewhere. In here, I think.
You turning us around again?
It was visible in the cutscene, but it's like not anywhere. Must be the other direction.
Keep a cool head.
Thank you.
deal with you. Appreciate it. This'll be quick. This'll be quick. This'll be quick.
Pulsework Knight just pushing Hope across the map.
I'll deal with you. Thank you. I'll deal with you.
Let's get this over with. New strategy! Thank you. me up.
Like I planned.
It's unfortunately looking like Vanilla is going to be the best saboteur. Grenades.
You know what to do.
Noctula kills.
This'll be quick. Time for another approach. Keep out of it. Target's a target.
You're gonna squirm! On your knees!
No problem.
Oh, yeah, okay. This is the place I was remembering with the bridges and the king behemoths and stuff. Thousand Noctu whatever's.
Back me up! Change of plan. This'll be quick. This'll be quick.
Ha!
just another battle. Let's get this over with.
I think a King Behemoth busts out of this door. Maybe that's the upstairs bridge.
Nothing I can't handle.
Thank you. You're gonna squirm!
they come from this direction? I think so. Oh, I remember these dudes.
These things are alive.
What's this sanctum up to? Are they planning to start a war?
Shouldn't run here. Suppose we're opening.
nothing I can't handle.
Get this over with.
I'll deal with you.
Appreciate
new strategy.
That would have been overpowered in a lot of fights.
Let's get this over with.
Come on, dude.
I'll deal with you.
Here,
appreciate. Keep the enemy off balance.
Change of plan.
Okay. Maybe I misunderstood the screen or something.
This'll be interesting.
You're gonna squirm! quick.
I can only see three on screen.
This will be quick.
Please heal me.
On your knees!
Don't worry.
This will be quick.
Thanks.
This will be quick.
Easy, guys. It's all right. Reigns is a sanctum officer. He's been helping us out.
Why are you here?
Reigns! You traitor!
Stop with the sword with his hand?
I put you on the path. That was my focus.
You're a lessee?
Since long before we met, I did my best to assist you, as bid by the Sanctum fal'cie. Now do you understand?
Yes, he is the boss.
The fal'cie have watched over you, guiding your every step. The luck that saved you time and again was a deliberate machination. Why, you may ask? The Primarch, or should I say, Bartendalus, is crafting you into the instruments of Cocoon's demise.
We've been played for fools.
A Cocoon fal'cie? Why?
Kind of obvious. He was explaining that.
To restore the Maker.
The Maker?
the entity responsible for creating both humans and fal'cie. Long ago, the Maker departed this world, leaving the two races behind. In a sense, human and fal'cie are brothers, orphaned by the same parent. As for the humans, they forgot the order imposed by the Maker. They began to war amongst themselves for the first time in history. The fal'cie focused on recalling their lost deity and returning the world to its former glory. This purpose lies at the heart of all their actions. Calling back the Maker requires a fitting sacrifice.
Yeah, we've heard. The destruction of Cocoon.
The lives of this world's entire populace in bloody tribute.
No, that's crazy talk.
I don't get it. Why do they need us? Couldn't the fal'cie end Cocoon with just a thought?
Their existence is bound to the creation and maintenance of this floating shell. It is their very nature that holds them in check.
You mean Cocoon fal'cie can't destroy Cocoon? They needed tools.
If we can stop this by doing nothing... we'll do nothing.
Noble, I expected as much.
Lie to us.
What happened to your dream of rebuilding Cocoon for the people? Was it all a lie?
A shadow of a dream from when I was human. It was change I craved, and once I'd built the influence to make things happen, there was change. I gained all the power I could hope for, but was a puppet with no will to wield it. It wasn't the fal'cie who changed. It was me.
You were made a lassie?
A lassie, tied to an inescapable focus, a slave of destiny. I'd lost hope. I'd all but given up on dreams of freedom.
What are you saying?
I'm here of my own accord, not by fal'cie order.
Yes, sir. I think this boss fight's
gonna
be annoying.
Seeing you fight brought it all back. Brought back that future I once strove for. I too will challenge my fate. If I can defeat you here, the fal'cie plan will fail.
Reigns!
I will use all my remaining power. I will set you free!
Reigns!
My triumph is near!
This'll be quick.
Give it your best shot. Take down the enemy.
You are mine. I will set you free.
Follow my lead.
The fal'cie has
follow my lead!
Appreciate it.
heal.
Let's go! This'll be quick. Give it your best shot.
You are mine!
Follow my lead!
The fal'cie has no hold over me! My will is my strength! I will not die a fal'cie slave! The fal'cie has
no hold over me! My will is my strength!
Careful now! Thanks.
I'm sure I should have beaten him by like 4 times by now.
Thank you.
His focus?
I don't think so. All Reigns did was try to save Cocoon in his own way. His own way.
Hey!
Where are you?
Snow! I think Reigns was searching. Searching for a way to make us understand. To understand the frustration of being a lacie bound to a focus, and maybe what it meant to be human.
quick.
Turn the tide!
Instinct.
You're gonna-
Guess they don't train fal'cie to make peace.
Lightning.
Let's wrap this up.
This'll be quick.
Turn the tide! You're gonna squirm! Let's wrap this up!
This'll be quick.
Turn the tide!
This'll be quick.
Give it your best shot. Now! You're gonna swerve!
Go!
Turn the tide!
Go!
Thank you.
Let's go!
this game really is cool. I just wish it was less near and the camera didn't suck so bad so you could actually see it. Oof. Please make this chapter end. It doesn't need to drag on this long. We're done here. We've seen all there is to be seen. I'm sure there's another boss at the end, too. Yeah, it's probably right here. So I think the last boss is Fang's idol.
Can fal'cie find and use these?
Turn around, please. Oh, bullshit. Is it both of them? Unfortunately, these dudes are like, they're really not a big deal unless you just sit there and do nothing. Or you're somehow underpowered. Why is there a launch now? I guess she can't launch this guy? Well, now it works. I can't step over this thing. I guess I'm gonna have to... Ground, buddy. Don't want to have a fair fight. Damn it. Okay. Yes, that worked. This game has very weird glitches in the combat where characters will just stand there. Even when they're supposed to be attacking. It's not very often, but it does happen. Okay.
Oh shit, I should have saved.
It's a dead end.
It's like a destroyed city.
How about down there?
If the stories are right, it's a maze.
This place is a boot camp for fal'cie. All kinds of challenges from Grand Pulse are waiting.
Challenges, huh? To get us all ready to go wipe out Cocoon?
We can wait here if turn in Seath sounds better.
I have had enough of this! Where's the way out?
Way out? Who said there was one?
Bring it on.
Tired of these motherfucking stakes on this motherfucking plane.
Maybe I will end up a Seath. But until that happens, I'm gonna make Sarah proud. I couldn't bring myself to admit that this tear meant goodbye. That's why I kept searching for her. But I didn't need to. Sarah was here the whole time. Right here, watching over me. Now I get it. What this tear's been telling me is to not let our focus win. It's not the fal'cie we should listen to. It's Sarah and Reigns. Do you know why? Our focus doesn't matter. What matters to me is that we protect Cocoon, whatever it takes.
Same here. I'll help you do it.
All right. I'm in.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
When a chocobo agrees, you know you're on the right path.
There you go. That's
well,
right.
Count me out.
What? Mm-hmm.
If you all want to go it on your own, then so will I.
Hey,
Fang.
Hey.
Let Cocoon get what's coming. They hate us for being fal'cie. What's it to me if they die? Better that than watch a friend go Seath. If you don't have the nerve for it, I'll do it myself. Go on alone. Get stronger. And smash Cocoon out of the sky!
Oh, Fang!
You turn Seath.
So I think this is the boss fight.
Back.
I think that no one's come to smack some sense into you when you start straying from the path, right? Yeah. This is the end of the chapter. I don't really like the only reason that each character gets an Idol one is just to tie into the story because they're pretty much useless. Only the party leader can use them, and you can only summon them once per battle anyway.
Come to take pity on me? Come to take care of a broken fal'cie?
That thing's here to help us?
Yeah, help. That's what Eidolons do. They help us. Eidolons are our salvation. If we can't decide what to do next, they come put us out of our misery!
Wait, so you haven't made up your mind yet?
Why are you protecting me? What are you doing?
Protecting one of our own. We can do without their brand of mercy. And we don't need a fal'cie's orders either. I'm fighting this focus to the end. We all are. So please, fight
the fuck
with
up.
Us.
Sure, what the deal is with the frame rate on these pre-rendered scenes.
Ah!
This is a joke, right? Can I heal, please? No? Okay. So IGN's strategy guide is wrong as fuck, like usual.
Too light to beg. You can do it! Hey!
Actually, they may be right. We're almost there.
End of the run.
No, goddammit. I keep getting diversity on accident. Oh, yeah. Okay, we got this. Yeah, they're... My bad, IGN was right about this one time. They said it should take you around until 300 on the deep counter. You get a Bahamut. Actually, I was saying earlier, the character models themselves could
maybe
also be improved.
I don't suppose you'd be willing to call it a
if they did a remaster.
Right. No. Okay. Listen, keep our eyes on the goal, and we'll figure something out.
I doubt they even still have the data for this game, though.
Hey, Sarah. So I guess being a lassie doesn't have to mean you can't do what's right, does it?
Oh, it's still not over?
Here's a shocker for you.
Can I go back to the safe one?
Guess it's time to face the peril of our fight.
What was the point of having a walkway if you can't even get halfway down the walkway before another cutscene happens?
What? Oh. An airship?
And it's from Grand Pulse. I guess it was one of this Ark's weapons or something.
That's a gate to Grand Pulse.
Oh, the parade thing I'm thinking about is near the end of the game.
That's our exit?
It's after you come back from Grand Pulse.
Could be one of Dysley's traps.
Well, that's not good. Do you think it might take us to Eden?
Mm-mm. I'm doing the flying. No more of these ships taking charge of our travel plan stuff. The only place this thing is taking us is where these boys tell it to.
Really? That is a Grand Pulse ship.
Really? Leave it to me.
Either way, we're on borrowed time. So we might as well go. We get lucky, maybe we'll even turn up some way to get rid of these goofy tattoos.
Is this Roger Craig Smith that,
You never know.
Was,
Maybe we just didn't think to look for one.
If nothing else, we know Cocoon's safe for the time being. I'd say it's worth going to take a look.
Maybe. But what about your dad?
I made him a promise. I promised him to keep going and do what I had to. He said only I would know what that was. The world's full of lies. There's no way of knowing what's right. All we can do is believe in ourselves. It's easy to sit back and let people trick you. Like how the Sanctum had us all thinking that a Lassie was some sort of monster. I'm done with their lies. Fal'cie, this whole focus thing. From here on out, I use my eyes. Think. And act. I might not make all the right choices, but as long as I'm the one who decided what to do, there's nothing to regret.
Okay.
All right, let's do it. I'm with you. Bad choices and all.
Of course, I'm not sure how it's gonna turn out. Pulse is hell, you know.
Oh, is it now? How many times have you been there?
None. But I want to go and see what it's like for myself.
Okay, people. So, everybody in?
Right,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Off to hell we go.
So wait, Hope still doesn't have an idol one.
No one ever said the future'd be easy.
Or Vanille.
But I think we all saw the glimmer of a dream. Somewhere in the sky that night. A spark of hope that we could change our fate. Who could say? That moment's come and gone.
Playful little critter, isn't he?
Yeah, we'll play with someone else.
Happens all the time.
He thinks we're lunch.
Yeah, like a seafood buffet.
Seafood, cute.
Guys, here it comes!
Do they actually have oceans on cooking?
Fang! Get him!
I'm on it!
Here!
What's happening?
Here goes.
Did someone fall out? We're going after them?
Hey! Over here!
You okay?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, everyone,
I'll
apparently.
Where more?
Huh.
sweet home. Welcome to Grand Pulse.
All right, so that's chapter 10.